If I should stay, I would only be in your way. So I.
Lisa, Lisa!
How are you?
I stopped.
We met in 1967.
At a
drive-in theater.
I believe she might be
with this lady here. No, with her. With this one.
She was with this wonderful lady, Susie, in
a red baron.
A red baron. A red falcon. I don't know if you guys even know what that is. And at that time, in 1967, she was a blonde. And I remember, as my friend and I were walking up to the Red Falcon, I said, I want the blonde. So we sat in my buddy's car and listened to Jimi Hendrix and Purple Haze the rest of the night.
We did.
Well, we got married in 1971. I had just gotten out of my basic training in the Army. I was bald as a billiard. No, I'm making up for it.
Nice mullet, Dad. Huh? Nice mullet.
Nice mullet.
Long mullet.
All right.
Go on.
Anyway, we got married. We got married November 5th, 1971, and we moved. We had our wonderful honeymoon. We drove to after our wedding, we went to Huntington Beach. We went to Huntington Beach. We went through an episode of Living Hell for a year and a half. Stole everything out of Volkswagen, three or four. It was an experience. But anyway, I took her to the airport. She went home.
I did.
I asked for a transfer to go back to California. I got it in a couple months. And I had Brother Doug.
Anybody that's ever worked with, lived with, loved with,
hung out with, Jan, knows that she is a glasses half full kind of person,
right?
Yep.
So that is probably, we have a whole nother speech plan, but we're not going to do it tonight. It's called Janisms.
They're the best.
Such great terms as not a lot of.
Not a lot of.
Or I'm not capable.
I am not capable.
But we won't go down that path. No, but real quickly, what I will say is that Jan is obviously my mother-in-law, and you know what, she is a savior to any of us that have ever spent any time with her, because you know what, it could be a Hurricane Katrina, it could be something terrible going on, it doesn't matter, it could be changes at work, I'm sure, it could be anything, but Jan is always going to look at it from the bright side, and that's what we love about you. And that's why, secretly, why I had you come over and hang out with me and Lisa sometime. Because I'm like, I just need somebody that is like...
Oh, shit. Yeah, backtrack on that.
So, to be fair, sometimes it's me that's not bad. Jan's going to be digging me out of this one. So, no, honestly, what I will say, though, is that she's always positive, she's always sweet, she's always patient, she's always kind, she's never mean, she's never hurt anybody, she's never been vindictive, and so we always love that about you.
And she's a whole lot of fun.
I think,
she's a whole jam humor!
Yeah, and I think tonight's, attendance and everything is a testament to all the people and all the lives that you've touched. So I consider myself blessed to have known you, blessed to call you family, and I will say that we're all blessed by your presence. So,
cheers!
And your glass is half full.
Yes. Cheers! Cheers!
Bitch, 1967. I don't know how that happened.
No.
Because you were dating me.
And
I was my brother Mike going to
the prom. You didn't have anything to do with my brother actually dating you?
No.
Oh, I think so.
I think so.
So anyway, I love Jan more than I can even say. Jan gave me my first Led Zeppelin album.
Well, I haven't done that.
But, wait for it.
Okay.
She also asked me when she gave me the album, which one's Led?
No. Who's Led Zeppelin Lynn?
So anyway, Jan and I and Bob and the family have gone through an incredible life. And I'm so glad. In 2013, we lost our son. Katie and I lost our son. It brought our family back together. I thank you.